this video, we will explain why it's important to inform the apprentice about different career and training possibilities in the company. It's a question about motivation and setting goals for the mentoring plan. We start with the question, why it's important to inform the apprentice about the internal promotion and training possibilities. Not only the company's employees are looking into the future for different career possibilities. The same applies for apprentice too. Apprenticeship is mostly the first time where youngsters think about different career paths. It is important that they understand what they must know to reach their goals. It helps to plan their career from the beginning right. They can already start during the apprenticeship with the extra training, or they can change their syllabus at the university, adding some extra subjects what are important for their dream career. Good example in Estonia is that after the apprenticeship, most students understand that Russian language opens a lot of doors. An important question is, when is the best time to discuss career possibilities? The best time to discuss career possibilities is the meeting where you plan your mentoring and apprenticeship plan. The apprentice has already some knowledge about the company's activities, and perhaps the apprentice already has a dream position in your company. Find that dream out and plan your program according to that. It helps to motivate the apprentice and you have more precise goals for your mentoring plan. It is the key for successful apprenticeship. The path to the apprentice dream job during the apprenticeship could be like this. In the first discussion with the apprentice, we try to find out whether the apprentice already has a dream position. When not, then you must find out what the apprentice like to do the most. For example, some people love office jobs, others want to go out, meet clients, travel. Easy questions like, do you love to travel? Do you enjoy discussions with people? This kind of questions will give you some input for your mentoring plan. When you have found out for the apprentice a possible dream position in your company, then give the apprentice some time to be inside this department. For example, after 1 week, have a feedback meeting, discuss his or her opinion about previous experiences. When the apprentice feels that there is a lack of knowledge in some fields, like special software skills, language skills, add some extra training to the mentoring and the apprenticeship plan to support and motivate the apprentice. It is important that you catch the right time to increase the complexity of tasks during the apprenticeship. This step must be organic and not very wide. Give the apprentice the possibility to give feedback, not only about his or her achievements, but also about the department. Take the input, for example, ideas, how to change some workflows seriously. Good answer would be, let's try. But of course, the most important is to be flexible. The dream job for the apprentice is only a cherry on a cake. The apprenticeship must give a wider view about different positions and connections between different departments. The apprentice must learn that nothing is coming easily. You must work on your dreams. Therefore, there are some risks what you must take into account. It's important that the dream job during the apprenticeship does not become a fixed idea. You must explain to the apprentice that the way to your dream job goes through different positions. Some you like, and from some you're learning something, or you get some extra experiences. For example, the best CEOs starts in the production line. And with years, when he or she understands the feelings and the contribution of his colleagues, grows to a great leader.